Welcome back, everybody. Today, for this video, we're going to look at. And we're over in Lips of Limits. We're gonna go over here to the crap classes. We're going down to Born Guy. 10 quests. Seven quests. Rising from the rolling maze of the Rotano Sea. The city-state of Limps Limits is home to the finest armors of the realm. Their aspiring artisans toil under the sharp eye of Hanaza. Nunza. Head of the armorer's guild. Hammer in hand and a passion for plating. Armorcraft. Sound of hammers bringing you in from the streets, did it, lad? Well, that you find that fighting for the armorer's guild is not the place for quiet revelry. The clangor of metal striking metal, music to ears may help you show the spirit of a shipwright. Are you of a mind to join our guild? Take it from me, lad, there's no greater joy than working a shapeless lump of iron into a shiny breastplate with your own hands. What say you then? Well then, lad, now that you can, we should cover a bit of guild history before forging ahead with the formality. The armor's craft is an offshoot of blacksmithing. Time was when the armors and smithies were one and the same. But as the years trickled by, the techniques of working metal, the armor plates became a specialized trade, and the smithies who showed uncommon skill and passion in this trade earned themselves a title of armor. Now, as you could probably imagine, skills necessary for making armor are also needed for shipbuilding, but building ships is a bit harder than knocking out simple helms, which led these armors who were good enough to work on boats to claim the title of shipwright. Of course, it was one thing calling the armors black. Brass armors, but it's also quite another calling shipwrights blacksmiths. Because building a ship and making a hatchet couldn't be more different. Seems as though a line needed drawn, and seeing as how Limps of Limits was built on the strength of the navy, and you can imagine how the armors chose to cut the ties from the smithies and established a guild of their own. As for the smithies, well, the whole nation of the independent armors guild, notion of an independent armor skill never did sit well on them, and there's always a fair old rivalry between our two factions ever since. Always trying to outdo each other, we are. Which is why we're ever at the lookout of new talent to help us keep the mini bass at the price. He was impressed, Forge Master. Start you on your training. You won for matter, Hansa. Helen can strip the scales off a fish back and fold it paper. Saying that you won't find a fair mistress out of the Strait of Marathon. Let me know when you muster the courage to speak with her, and I'll see to the rest. Mine's made up, you ready to throw your lot with us armors? And made yourself known to the Forward Master. No empty title, by the way, and also a renowned shipwright and one of the finest crafters in Limps of Limits. Head outside and you'll find her blistering the skin and newest. of the aspiring armorer, are you? Welcome, I am Hananza, Lord Master of the Guild. I take it that Gwanako
has explained to you the history and nature of our craft. Good. Little to add on that front, save this. The life of an armorer is not an easy one. Day after day, you will be pit flesh and blood against iron and flame, and without a passion for the forge, you will fail. But passion alone will not make an armorer of you. Truly master this craft, you must possess with a will as unyielding as the metals you work. Knowing what lies before you, have you the fortitude to persevere? Ah, no fear of hard work. That is well. Consider your request to join the guild approved. If you ever give me aught less than your best, you will be out the door before you realize my boot has connected with your backside. You're clear on that? Good. Now that we understand each other, let us begin with the basics. What is your name? Eligos. Well, Eligos. The tool is called the Donning Hammer. Here, grip it firmly. Don't wait. Let me know when you feel comfortable with it in your hand. If you're holding it properly. Ah, yes. I didn't know better. I'd think you were an armorer, Eligos. Of course, I do know better. Though your craft something with that hammer of yours looked like a babe with a rattle. No intention of mothering you. No mistake. I mean to shape you into an artisan. Whatever hard I have to pound. Save your sweat for the forge, lad. Expect you to fashion full suits of plate on your first day. Pay close attention to your instructions. Turn it to work, and it will come in due time. Now, let's be with your first lesson, shall we? I want you to take up your hammer and make me a bronze ingot. Same task, I grant you, but one which every armorer must master. Bronze, you see, is the most basic material of the craft, and bronze ingots are building blocks. It is not the strongest of allies, of course, but it is that very quality that makes bronze so easy to shape and the choice for an armorer. To forge your ingot, you will need to procure two chunks of copper ore, a chunk of tin ore, and an ice shard. The ore can be purchased from Spinnerweb here at the guild. Shard, you'll have to drown. Well, you waiting for me to swing your arm for you, or mayhap you would have me swing my boot? There's a bronze ingot for Forge Master Hananza. Using two chunks of copper ore, a chunk of tin ore, and a nice shard. Begin the crafting process, blah 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 blah. Whip.
Oh, you want to do it.
Two copper, two tin.
Where's that bronze ingot I asked you for? You can't find the ore yourself. Try speaking with Smearweb here at the guild.
Did your first task, have you? Well then, have a look at this ingot. This is the sort of quality I can expect for you, is it? I'm a armorer. This is excellent work. Excellent! Well done, Eligos! The key to making good bronze is judging the ratio of copper to tin. Much tin, the other becomes harder, also more brittle. The sort of material you want protecting your vital organs. Lest you forget, quality is a matter of life and death in our craft. It is why we teach our initiates the ideal metallurgical composition of every item we forge. Not that all are quick to learn, there are some who are destined to produce mediocre results, however painstakingly the processes are explained. Like the builder, you are not one of them. I'm pleased to say that your ingot would fetch a decent price in the markets. And do not let this first success make you complacent. A single bad helm will lose you more trust than 100 good ones will. Because bad armor means dead men. Not enough that your work is good. It must be consistent. And achieving the consistency requires discipline and long hours of crafting the same item over and over again and again. For you, this means a mountain of bronze ingots. Bronze ingots in your dreams. Bronze ingots until the process is so ingrained in you to wake up and find that your pillow is an ingot you made in your sleep. When you feel that you have learned all that you can from forging bronze ingots, seek me out and I'll find you something else to craft. Build or guard your hand, Alus. Ah, Eligos, I take you up. Now intimate with every aspect of the bronze ingot production. Good. Will assist us in a pressing matter. It seems one of our young members, Within, accepted an order which he would struggle to fulfill in thrice the time he promised. While I was tempted to let him squeal under the weight of his own ambition, Hilda's not in the habit of delivering late. Several veteran armorers have volunteered their services, but I would also like you to assist in the matter. On the one hand, you will be able to spare the guild unnecessary embarrassment. On the other, you will be deepening your understanding of the craft. The builder could not have planned it better. For your part in the endeavor, you shall craft 3 bronze hoplons. Need bronze plate and maple lumber to make the shields. While we're on the subject, how have you been acquiring your materials? Markets are a reliable source, but have you considered making an arrangement with a miner or botanist? As you will have gleaned, the craft calls for a near constant supply of copper and tin, both of which are commonly mined in the region of Thanalin. Should your purse grow too light for comfort, there's little to stop you taking up the pickaxe yourself. For the time being, however, I want you to concentrate on honing your skills as an armorer. With the fundamentals under your belt, hoplon shouldn't prove too challenging. And do not fall into the trap of complaints. Poorly wrought shield is worse than no shield at all. Every piece of your craft, whatever simple, must reflect utmost attention to detail. The guild proud, Alagos.
Right.
3.
comes with. Plans. Fires. How fare you with your task? Do you have those three hoplons for me? Impressive, you have managed to balance the conflicting requirements of steadiness and portability, much as you balance hardness and malleability the first time. Bronze plate is securely fitted and should weather the most vicious blows without becoming dislodged. And importantly, your work was swift and sure. Ian armor has lost a sale due to late delivery and rightly slow. So, customers' need for armor is terribly pressing, and its absence is like to be surely felt. Given the stakes, a reputation of reliability mean handsome profits, especially at a time when the Maelstrom is seeking armorers to outfit its ever-expanding ranks. It is all we can do to keep pace with the Grand Company's orders for equipment. That is why each member of the guild must support the next, such as the warriors of Eld supported their fellows in the phalanx. Links with the. Though we would have but recently begun your training, a man of your natural talents belongs to the front line. The time has come for you to learn use of another weapon, the armor's arsenal, specifically pliers. Take this pair and try using them in combination with your hammer. Will feel strange at first, but persistent, and you will. But persist, and you'll find that your work proceeds damn slight more smooth. Master the pliers, I would like to see the results of your dedication. Till then. Hello, Ghost. Just the lad I was hoping to see. Nishia is near exhausted of my reserves of patience. I think she would benefit from seeing the results of a peer's dedication and skill. Be yours. Her name is Grinning. Good day. Builder, help me. She is the most distracted, thumb-fingered woman ever to lift hammer. She could but learn to forge the simplest without constant. I would consider it a rare victory. It's unfortunate that Byregot did not see fit to invest all of my armors with your innate talents. I suppose you must all start somewhere. If I abandoned every initiate that was slow to grasp a technique, our guild would have a grand total of 10 members? Maybe 10. But would be a few enough for our clients in the Maelstrom to have their share bracelet. So, what say you, Elagos? You only craft a dozen sheets of bronze plate to supplement Grenin's. When they are ready, I want you to deliver them to the lass in person. Your example will inspire her to take more care with her work. 12 bronze plate. And lag. My voice. Doing all right? My noise gate might be up a little too high or something. My pet, Alpha. The reason why I'm part of the maelstrom. I already got one. One at a time because I don't want any high quality. All normal quality. Texture. Thank you. Oh, you must be Elagos. Guildmaster told me that you be... Wait, where did I put my hammer? Oh, there it is. Sorry, what are you saying? Right, yes, I would be most grateful for extra sheets of Blown's plate. What? Did you craft these yourselves? Like, they're absolutely... Whoa, I nearly dropped them. Oh, no harm done, though. Was saying, I certainly see why the Forge Master speaks so highly of your work. Plus its perfect color and thickness, so I assume you carefully measured out the amounts of tin and copper. I always add too much tin. Do you know the metal? No metal can shatter? Well, I didn't. Truth be told, I tended to put all my effort in making the armor itself rather than bothering with the base materials. I mean, compared to hammering out glorious winged helms or innate greaves, measuring out metals just seems so trivial. But looking at your work, I'm beginning to wonder, I never realized how beautiful a simple sheet of metal materials like this. Just imagine the sturdy, shining suits are great. It seems that I've been putting the cart before the chocobo. This moment onwards, I swear to focus all my attention and care on the task at hand, even if the task at hand is for. And what of you, Elagos? Do you have any grand projects waiting for you? Oh, I overheard some of the senior armorers boasting about the coin they made through Craycraft League. Might that be something you consider? They say to Monkey over at the Drowning Wench is the one to talk to you. That's where I'll be heading once I improve my techniques. Now, where did I put that hammer? Where have you been, Elagos? Work to be done. Need you to speak with another novice. Asked by the name of Dwitzwida. Dwitzwida. I was due a barbet and a buckler from her a few bells ago, and I find myself standing here with Neri and Noseguard. Unless you wonder, Dwitzwida is nothing like Renee. She is as dedicated to the craft as you are, but I've never known her to miss a delivery. Something must be amiss. I need to find out what. I'd go and ask her myself, but I fear my usual approach would do more than harm than good. Lass might be built like a stack of anvils, but she flinches at the merest hint of That's why I decided to assign you as Dwitzwida as supervisor for this job. Keen on you for this sort of thing, Elagos. Pleasure to meet you, sir. The Forge Master had to interrupt your work so that you might assist mine. I do hope you're not angry. I don't know if I could endure another dressing down. As pathetic as it sounds, that's actually the reason my delivery is late. Can't bring myself to work. I should start from the beginning. A while ago, I received a visit from an armorer by the name of Blanstier. He's one of the old guard, true veteran of the guild. After but a single glance at the armor I made, he yelled at that my work wasn't fit to cover a kobold's arse, and now I cannot banish the scene from my mind. His face twisted in anger with scornful words. Am I truly so talented? It paralyzes me. He had explained the flaws of my work, I might endeavor to correct them, but I couldn't bring myself to speak to him, anyone else for that matter. Well, now, why don't you speak with Blunsteel? Enough? Know the reason behind this reprimand.
Aye, I'm Blunsteel. If you're looking for an armor with skill and integrity, you found him. What are you after, then? Eh? You want to know what's amiss with Dwitzwida's work?
Faces.
All those whelps training under Ananza. They've got their heads filled with daft, bloody notions of cooperation, camaraderie, when what they should be learning is how to use a pair of pliers. I'd yet to meet one of her novices who could forge an ingot worth of them. And them, and as ain't got the skill, ain't worth me time. Which means you, boy. Bugger off. Not budging, eh? Stubborn sod. All right, then. Tell you what. I'll give you one chance to prove yourself. Let's see you craft the same pieces as your friend made such a meal of. Decorated bronze barbet and a bronze buckler. Buckler it were. And if you're half decent, you'll have yourself a nice little chat. Bring me a decorated bronze barbet and his bronze buckler. Are you getting nut out of me, save curses and weeping sack of hog and shite? Back at last, are ye? I'm beginning to think he's crawled off to old dot to buy the damn things from a back alley peddler, he wrote. Let's have a look, shall we? Bugger me. Are you sure you made these yourself? Huh. Seems at least one of our nuns' whelps knows the difference twixt hammer and sledge. Builder, take me. He has some talent, lad. Barbet well shows the character of your work, precisely and uncompromising as it should be. You realize that forging a helm ain't a matter of slapping a few molded sheets and bronze together nice. Your buckler's just as good. Small and light and a bit slight sturdier than the shield's twice the size. I didn't expect to be saying this, but I'm impressed. With this level of quality and polish, you can make a tidy living yourself as an artisan. But you're the exception as proves the rule, lad. Fact is, the other novices ain't fit to lick your boots. Your Swila included. So you tell her this from me. If you're the time to wallow in wounded tears, you're the time to examine your own mistakes. There's no room in this world for craftsmen as they can't criticize their own work. Handiwork. To learn how to gauge your failings and correct them. Bring up your bloody hammer.
Well.
You know, sometimes people can't see the mist. Hang up your bloody hammer. Oh, for passing on, but. Well, thank you for passing on Blanster's advice. I believe I understand what he means to say, but not everyone has the inner fortitude to endure such criticism, be it for oneself or others. Such strength is required to master the armor's art, and mayhap I've taken my calling. Joined the guild with the dream of following in Hananza's footsteps, but I see now that it was folly. I shall have to think long and hard about my aspirations. Please convey my apologies to the board masters.
Ah, so it's Blandsteer that caused this mess. The bastards always did take it upon themselves to weed out the weaker initiates. Not exactly in the best of terms, he and I, even after all this time. I've known Blandsteer since we were not but wide-eyed novices, serving our apprenticeships under the same master. We always had our differences, but when our master retired, they became that much more stark. And when we both put ourselves forward for the role of Forge Master, the resulting contest drove a permanent wedge between. Blanster's arguments are not entirely without merit, but neither is his approach. The only way to train new armorers. But that damnable curmudgeon, though, it is his way and no way at all. The idea of nurturing aught less than God's given talent is anathema to him, and his ears wax deaf at the mere mention of it. Outfitting an army is the work of more than a talented few, it is a work of many hands acting in unison. I have turned a blind eye to Blanster's behavior until now, and if he would threaten the unity of this guild, something must needs be done. Think on it.
How fare you, Elgos? Have you had any further dealings with Blanster?
No. I hope his bile is not done to wear away at your better judgment. Lest you think me unjust, I do not dispute his skill with the merely take issue with the lack of respect he shows to those he deems inferior. He is responsible for breaking the spirits of more than a few errors, ranks suffer for it. Cannot in good conscience remove his name from the guild register. All of his flaws, Blanster's knowledge and experience would be too great a loss. Then I must find a way to soften the old buzzards. That I require your assistance. I'll not unfold his thoughts to me, but mayhap he will do to you. Don't look so surprised, you're one of the few armorers in his place when he wouldn't see cast out. He may possess all the charm of a rabid courier, but he does have a fine eye for talent and an appreciation for well-crafted goods.
make him one of your best iron hoplons, and I dare say he'll share his thoughts. But I should warn you. Some of your web has informed me that we scarcely have sufficient iron plate to cover our existing commissions. We'll have to look elsewhere. Hawker's Alley will almost certainly have what you need, but there is always the option of mining it yourself. Either way, I apologize for putting you into additional trouble. One last thing, I want you to meld the materia to the finished shield. That should get odds attention. A vacant stare does not inspire confidence. Ghost, brief, materia is the crystallized essence of a well-worn piece of equipment. Those crystals are attached to other gear to enhance very. If you would know more, you would consider paying Mutamix in Central Thanalan. Teach you about the process of enhancing equipment using materia. Oh, and he's a goblin. Now, the shield you craft must embody all the knowledge and skill you have gained thus far. It would serve to convince Blanster that you are a little like-minded soul and prompt him to speak. Back out of the ghost, guard your hand. I have a better idea.
Slightly different. Gonna spend no money on.
Thank you.
Iron plates. What do you want? Nuns, have you running errands again? What's this? Brought me a shield, have you? With materia, impressive. But don't imagine a bit of materia is enough to make up for shoddy workmanship. Ain't the kind to be blinded by sparklies, lad. Now let's have a closer look. Bugger me. This is when they'd have this. They make the step up from bronze to iron that the weaker craftsmen start to show their limitations. The metal being a damn slight harder to shape. All manner of flaws creep into their work.
There ain't a single bleeding one in this shield. Your arm and blows were steady and measured. And you kept the thickness of the iron nice and even, too. No bugger wants his shield splitting in half coat because the armor beat a bit of the plate too thin. And piece of work, this. Damn fine. That's twice you passed me inspection now. I'm convinced you're the kind of skill that demands respect, lad. So, as one artisan into another, let me ask you a question. What are your thoughts about the Hananzas handling the guild? I know you ain't been with us for long, but you must have been wondering what she's playing at, am I right? If you ask me, the soft-hearted wench is belittling the damn place with budding amateurs that are armors and naught but name. Armors crafts gear as keeps men alive. Lack the skill or the experience to make ink armor and as will do that job, there's no business holding a hammer. Just imagine what would happen if a breastplate made by one of them lackwits fell apart in battle. And not just for the poor bastard wearing it, neither. Talking about what's become of the guild's good name. The way Hananza's entrusted these novices with real craftsman work, she's spitting in the face of the builder. Only a tired old and tried and true armor could be taken on orders and dealing with valued patrons. By refusing to get rid of the dregs, Hananza's dampening the flames in our forges. Forge master, my arse. How could she be bloody blind? Hansa's doing a good job. Ah, there you are. Tell me, were you able to prize anything useful, Blandsteer? What did he have to say? Not dampening the flame, forges. Familiar refrain, that stubborn old sod will never understand why his way fail. Not that he's ever even thought to question it. If you choose not to pass on our knowledge, all the techniques and methods we perfected over the gods know how long are destined to perish along with us. Blandsteer bemoans the dampening of our forges. While advocating the course of which would see them extinguished altogether. That is why I will continue to expose all of our initiates to as many facets of the craft as I can, until such time as I die or am replaced. I may add that you yourself stand as a shining example of how effective this approach can be. I'll not force the issue, but you make the perfect champion for my cause. That said, Blandsteer has apparently come to much the same conclusion. In an order to ask for you by name. The order is for a single steel ingot, but being the difficult bastard that he is, doesn't want any ingot, wants an ingot of the purest. Will require the best materials you can get your hands on. Well, keep you any longer, what to do, and a cantankerous artisan to impress.
High quality. So steel ingot.
I need bomb ash, iron ore.
And then, like, things like that here. Trick me. Five more. Nope. Here to deliver that ingot, lad. Hey, one for a little chit chat. It feels great. Let's head inside and have a look. Knew you were up to the task, lad. Can't forge steel much purer than that. Is a common enough material, of course, but one's no special self-respecting armor. You should have any trouble working. But it's the quality of these common materials that makes the difference between crafting a work and a piece and a masterpiece. No matter how shiny you polish it, your work will never be more mediocre if the stuff you make it from is second rate. Any road, I can see that you've already learned that lesson, eh? Where every time our paths cross, you're twice the armor ye was before. And yet, Hanunza has a talented lad like you tidying up after bungling bloody novices. That have given ye the freedom to master your craft. Makes me blood boil, it does. In our guilds to survive, and it's got to be able to serve its customers' needs. Any bugger... as don't contribute to keeping a roof over our head, don't deserve to work. I have not but respect for you, Elagos. You're the kind of armor this needs more of. And tell me true, you're really content to waste your career wiping the arses of Hananza's hobbling bays? Your talent's been buried under a mountain of mediocrity. It's high time you did something about it. What? Well, for you to decide.
Talking about this. One standing on top of her. A bid to quell a mutinous murmurings within the guild for Master Hanunza is decided to it. Prestigious.
Ah, Elagos, the man whose name is on everybody's lips. In case you didn't know, the entire guild seems to be holding its breath, waiting to see which side you'll... Popular opinion is that you're ready to take up with Blandsteer. I have no such concerns, of course. Have you resolved to do yourself with me? You would not be having this conversation. What does... And that does not change the fact that your allegiance remains a subject of public debate. But it's the unity of the guild. I propose you dispel our colleagues' newfound anxiety by demonstrating your affiliation in a manner that none may doubt or dispute. Specifically, I would have you accept the commission of a valued client on my behalf. That, I think, will serve as a proof of both of my faith in you and of your support of the guild's present cause. Tell me, how would you like to try your hand at crafting a suit of steel chainmail? The order comes from a resident of Costa del Sol. Wealthy and gentleman, who will accept nothing less than the finest quality armor. As you may imagine, his patronage is of great value to the guild. Hardly add that I would not entrust this to an armorer in whom I have aught less. The client's maid servant, Northwind, will supply you with the finer details of the order. Here in the city, conducting business at the Fisherman's Guild as we...
I kind of can't wait to do this. That's kind of... Actually,
greetings, Sally. What an honor is to meet another of Linsa's famed artisans. I'm sorry? Commission? Oh. There be some... I've already entrusted my master's to a veteran craftsman of a esteemed organization. You are acquainted with Balanzier. His reputation precedes him, you see. I saw no reason that a man of his experience should be assigned the task. Oh, but I do mean to suggest... do not mean to suggest to you... I merely sought to justify my own intention. Incredible though that this situation may be, I would hesitate to name your colleague a mission, given all the sterling work he has done for us in the past, I mean. Yet, I am well imagined that you are loath to return to your superior, and assuming the efficient are exceptional, my master will provide full remuneration regardless of. Mayhap it would be best for all concerned if you discuss the matter with your fellow armor.
Come on, Blanster. That was... Plus, you're nowhere in your fourth. Out over here. Working.
Well, if it ain't Anunza's laptop, I heard about your little show at the other. I suppose Northwind told you I snatched that commission from right under your nose, did she? It seems you got yourself a thorny little predicament, don't you? I ain't about to hand the job back to you in a silver platter. That don't mean I want you to. Don't you see? This is a perfect chance to find out who's the better armor. To see which one of us is the right and proper path. I'm talking about a contest, a skill boy. Whichever of us craps the finer suit of chainmail gets it. But remember, this bloke ain't good coin, pays good coin for a reason. The best ain't about to settle for less. Not that he'll have to, of course you. Bloody fall is to be better than mine. Your mate will be getting his money's worth when it happens. Once you're ready, bring your armor back here and we'll lay it out next to mine. We've both got our pride, so I reckon you can judge the... Bugger off.
Breakdown.
All right.
think about doing these quests while a high level. I can use that high quality problem, but
well, pressure's too much for you, lad. Well, have you finally finished putting that chainmail together? Right then, let's have a look, shall we? My buyer got speared. Where'd you learn to forge links like that? It's bloody perfect. Roger himself would struggle to stick a dagger through the steel and look at that luster. Strength and beauty in equal goddamn measure. Nunza must be praising the builder for dropping a gift like you in it, like yourself, in your lap. You won fair and square, Oligos. I'll not bother to lecture you no more. Take your beauteous bloody chainmail to Northwind myself. Let her know who it was that's crafted it. It's an old tradition among armors, because you didn't know. The loser of these contests get the job of delivering the victor's goods. Bah, look while you can, lad. You just joined Hananza at the top of me list. Ain't over by a long shot.
It's better. Othgar has been like standing on top of Hananza for I don't know how long.
Greetings, Eligos. I hear word you bested Blunster in an armorous contest of skill. Impressive feat. No, but you should be proud. But I'm afraid you've made a most troublesome enemy, for he is both persistent and vindictive. As you well know, I speak for bitter experience on that matter. Rather than dwell on his unpleasant rivalry, however, I would have you focus on your craft. Ready your hammer and pliers, Eligos. Much and more to do. Master Lingsath over at the Bismarck has commissioned a new steel fry pan, and as one might expect from the head of the Culinarians Guild, he expects only the finest of wares. Now, compared to pounding out thick, protective plates of armor, cooking utensils, being generally smaller and lighter, require a somewhat more delicate touch. You must bring all of your concentration to bear, lest you risk running the entire place into an entire piece with a single misplaced blow. In light of recent events, which have no doubt left your mind scattered, I believe a task that fully engages your faculties will be proved beneficial. Let us not keep Master Lingsath waiting, Eligos. To the forge with you!
apparently. I'm not high enough patient with these. That kid.
Where's that fry pan? Now the ghost is time. It is true that you're no longer some rank novice, but I do not think your posterior is safe from the toe of my boot if you did that and that.
Another consummate work. Find no flaw with its weight or balance. It is not too so heavy as. He has struggled to lift, yet it seems steady enough to endure the frantic pain. I trust at this juncture that you comprehend all my earlier warning. To produce a fry pan of this quality would most certainly have required your undivided attention. I will tell that this item achieved just that. The sincere the metal's thickness is the evidence when...
This type of precision should not be undervalued. In this case, should the fry pan be poorly forged, the cookings of Flaws are unacceptable to an exacting culinarian such as Master Ling's. Even the sturdiest utensils, however, rarely last him more than a few seasons. Struggle to find armorers who can meet his demanding specifications when he turns to our guild for... I have long intended to assign this commission to you, but your encounter with Blansdeer had me doubting your ability to concentrate. One of those rare occasions when I am happy to be proven wrong. Your uncompromising attention to detail continues to be an inspiration for your colleagues. Ah, speaking of details, there's one means unattended. Delivering this fry pan to Master Ling's hand. First, you do not need directions, culinary.
You come to deliver me new fry pan, have ye? Oh, ain't she a beauty? This pan will be able to whip up all sorts of dishes, and you've not fret about burning the middle or undercooking the edges. You say this is your work? Only the forge master himself has ever been able to make utensils that I'd consider worthy of the Bismarck. Seems like I finally got me another craftsman I can trust. You're welcome to me kitchen new time, lad. Alright.
Alright, you be back because we're dealing with the pirate. Pirate City of Limsa Laminsa. With the armors. Arr. With me boy, Elagos. Handsome rugged in as they have iris. Gated. I don't know how to properly say it. Arr.
Arr has finally moved.
I hope you're feeling competitive, Eligos, for Blensteer has submitted a formal challenge. Seems he means to recover the pride you cost him with your previous. He is an overgrown, sulky child who sees his fellow colleagues as not more than rivals. In this tiny world, all that matters is who is best, who is the brightest, and who is the most able to provide immediate value to the I'd be lying if I said I did not also take such factors into account. You well know my demand for excellence, but the methods we take to reach it differ vastly. Landsteer would run a guild of exclusion, one in which an adventurer like yourself who most would have been unwelcome. Lack of sense in that, clear. He may be my equal in skill and technique, but it is this narrow perspective that weighed the balance against him in our contest with the Guildmaster chair. I won and he lost. So fact plays an enormous role in the enmity that now lies between us. I'm certain that past defeat is no small part of what fuels Blindsteer's present desire to prove himself your better. I regret that this ridiculous feud has drawn you into this bitter maw, but it is mean seeing that the stubborn old dodo put into his place. Then I'm just childish enough to encourage you to accept. Blindsteer awaits you for his usual haunt. Go to him and show you've the gauntlet thrown down.
Level 40 quest. Yeah, we got. I think I. No, three parter. Right.
I've had just about enough of Hananza's cuddling ways. She's raising a generation of slackers that look like armors, but ain't fit to wipe the soot off a proper craftsman's backside. Before you know it, folk will start losing trust in the trade itself. Years of pride and tradition are crumbling to dust around our feet. Of course, ever since he bested me in our little competition, me words don't carry the weight. Seems like I got to take you down a few pegs before I start putting things right. Aye, the world needs to know that old Blenster's got to be not to be beaten by one of Ananza's lot, even if it's a prize pup. We'll settle this the old-fashioned way. A three-round contest of skill. There ain't no point in dragging this out, so let's get straight to the challenge of the first round. The finest mithril and curious. Okay, so it's grass. When you say it fast, it sounds like queer ass. Anyways. With queer ass, we can forge. Since I'll be choosing the task, you'll leave the appraisal of your work to your precious forge master. I'll be taking the armor to you directly. Once you shun Hananza, your own cuirass. Send her decision. Yeah, bring the piece to me, so I'll see it for me.
All right, this I'm going to pain. First off, I need some metal. I need 15. Calypso. First things first. I need one ring. Oh, hear us. Lansdale has already been here to submit his work for appraisal. You have a mithril cuirass as prepared as well, I trust. This is superb craftsmanship, Elagos. Seems the pressures of this challenge have done not to cloud your eye for detail. In fact, you may have produced your finest piece yet. It is superior to Blenster's in every respect. Think me biased? It is true that I despise the self-centered windbag, and I mean to judge this contest. But I mean to judge this contest fairly. The Brogadin's armor was indeed forged from his customary quality, and it is thus that the brilliance of your cuirass shines all the more brightly for improving the work of an artisan. Mithril is a notably difficult material to shape, yet need the gloss of these, but a single imperfection to mar the surface. I have cast an eye over many suits, and it is refreshing to know that I can still be impressed. The first round goes to you. We wish I could be there to see Blanster's weep when you show him the masterpiece you have.
So, Nunza's changed your armor over mine, did she? Surprise, surprise. Come on, then, pup, let's see this bloody one. You've not been neglecting your craft, is it? That much is certain. Can't rightly disagree with her decision, but the first run will be, next run will be a different story. Go with that. You're right. Bannister has notified me of the challenge of the second round of the contest. Defeat in the first round has humbled him not a whit, it seems. You may have gained an early lead, Elegos, but keep your focus sharp. I've said before, complacency can be your downfall. A man like Blensteer is as at his most dangerous when his pride is on the line. Now, according to the wishes of our vindictive veteran for this next round, you will have to craft several items. You must do so within a reasonable time frame to reflect the pressures of an actual commission. He fails to mention that what he considers to be reasonable. So I suggest you work with dispatch. Challenge requires that you forge a pair of mithril plated caligae, a reinforced mithril ammo, and a pair of mithril sorians,
all of the finest possible quality. Naturally, every one of these items requires an abundance of mithril ore. See how he deliberately chooses the same material as before? Such as Benster's confidence in his ability and his certitude that he cannot be beaten twice under similar circumstances. This is your chance to unravel that obnoxious self-assurance and end this contest with a second round victory. If anyone can quench the fury of that insufferable Aurox, Aurox Elegos, you. Bring your submission to me once you have satisfied with your fortune. Take no shortcuts. I expect to see armor of unsurpassed quality.
This is gonna be... tricky. All right, anything, I'm not getting anything from the market board. Thank you.
in a little.
Thing it.
horns. There we go.
Oh, here's the thing. Instant. Thank you.
Everything I need. Yeah, I should probably use my...
Which is free!
Took a little longer, a little more finessing on this one. More to do.
Alright, step one.
Bulb.
Step two.
You have the pieces required for the second round. See a pair of mithril-plated caligae, a reinforced mithril elmo, and a pair of mithril swordlets. All the best quality you can muster. Well done, Elegos. Your work is flawless. I would declare you the victor this very moment, except I need you to relinquish this armor to the guild. As for the why, it concerns a potentially dire loss of reputation. Do you recall the time you aided one of our novices in an order of bronze hoplon? Well, Raid Young's within has failed to deliver once more. He has improved much in his craft. He has improved much in his craft, spurred on as he was by your example, and again the lad accepted a commission he could never hope to honor, and one does not break a promise made to the maelstrom. I could drop full responsibility for the failure within the smith's unreliable shoulders and guild, but what worth is a guild that must not to support its own members truly need? Lanster is a harsh man, but not entirely without reason. If you explain the circumstances, may grant you a few extra days. Let's see where it goes. Will you yield your work to the... Why? Because Elegos is a really good guy. Argos' blessing upon you, Elegos. Within, come over here and show some gratitude. I don't know how to repay you for saving my neck again. I'll never forgive myself for costing you your victory over Blanseer. But the compassion you and the Forge Master have shown me this day will not be squandered. This I promise you. Twice as hard. Three times even. We are in your debt. I arranged to have these pieces delivered to the Maelstrom Quartermaster to me. Meanwhile, hurry to Blanseer.
Yeah, Blensters.
What's this now? You let the guild have your armor to make up a missed order. What did it tell you? This good parasites are holding you back at every turn. It was meant to honor the terms of our contest, no matter the circumstances. Now you're neither the gear nor you crafted to show for your effort. Nor the time to forge your new submission. Crown goes to me. I'd grant you this ain't the kind of victory a man looks for, but rules is rules, lad. Failure comes from consequence. I don't want you to hear no excuses for the final round. Bring your best work to the table and you let that result stand for themselves.
That's right. Also, I mean, of course it's going to be like that because, you know, we have one more quest.
I must thank you again, Alagos, for sacrificing your time and effort to help our guild at order. It behooves us not to fail clients such as they are, no matter the reason. But as is your fate, you are rarely afforded a respite from the flames of the fire. I have recently been informed that Admiral Mirrorweb inspecting various organizations, the Armorer's Guild included, and their roles in promoting the Salamence's trade with the East. The impressions made during this inspection will have a direct influence on whom the Maelstrom chooses as the provider of its equipment and other sundry supplies. Lansteer, in his usual arrogance, proposed that we seize this opportunity to have the Admiral herself serve as arbiter for the final round of your contest. Ugh, imagine how that bastard will crow if we are to suffer defeat before the commander of Limsa Grand Company. The credence such as public failure would lend to their arguments would spell the end of the guild as we know it. You must not allow this to come to pass. Success in this third and final
The final challenge hinges on your ability to forge what might need to be the most exquisite cobalt aborigine.
Oh, help. Help me.
Abujan. We'll say that. In the realm. As you'd expect, it's one of the most demanding pieces of armor in a student of our discipline can attempt. While I harbor not the slightest doubt that you will produce a harbinger of surpassing quality, let us tip the scales in your favor by augmenting it with materia. Heaven's Eye materia of the third grade. Once your armor is complete, deliver it to Sergeant Swinbrook at Hucker's Round. You will see it passed along to the Admiral.
Cobalt.
Give me a little more to this. Hey. Now, all right, back to the... Do all this without spending a dime.
Burke, I'm gonna do. Where is it? wondering if look me.
Leather worker? Back to armor. One. And a mithril. Volt.
You read. And I put there. Late and.
I need Heaven's Eye materials. Do that, I mean.
Shopping.
Ugh. I need one. I don't want to spend that much money. Ugh. Doom. Now for the climax. And there goes Windgem. Ah, you have the Cobalt Halberjin for me, then. Would not be to keep Admiral Merrowib waiting.
There goes Blansir. This is the final round of your contest. The final round of your contest will decide victory and or defeat. Best armor win. Admiral, what are these gentlemen? Mannequins. I find little can be learned from the impossibly lifeless models, so I decided to take a different tact. My men here will wear your armor of submissions instead. You intend them to take on various poses? No matter of speech. I mean the quality of the armor. I prefer the direct brute. Irogoth's beard, what kind of appraisal is this? You're really that surprised, Sinzana? No finer way to test your gear than in the heat of battle. Flesh and blood warriors, tis hardly necessary. What the risk of injury?
Eh, the armor's been built to withstand far worse than this. If those blokes get hurt by them oversized hatchets, then hey, you got no business being here. You agree on that score, don't you, Elegance?
Well, it appears your claim to excellence is more than empty boast. Let's raise the stakes, shall we?
Admiral, you've gone too far.
Such expensive equipment is little use to us if it cannot stop a bullet. Unless you think me reckless, my men were never in real danger. I quite carefully inspected the steadiness of both Harbingers before we began. You are not the only one with an eye for quality. In any case, here's we have.
I don't believe it. The shot punched through me roomy links. That's so damn different about your armor and mine. Perhaps the reason you cannot answer that question, armor, is the reason you've lost
your colleague.
Bloody hells. This is an educational and entertaining experience. When the Maelstrom next finds itself in need of replacement equipment, I believe I know just the sort of armorer to whom I'll turn. Congratulations, Elagos! Close contact, but we struck a telling blow again today, nonetheless. Question is, does Blindsteel yet realize his fault? Best for you now to learn where we stand. Come to see me beaten and broken, have you? Bloody fool out of me. Ugh. Thick-headed stubbornness. Reckon I ought to steer clear of the guild business for you. You tell that harpy, Ananza, that she better not let this place fall to pieces. She'll be watching. How very like Blenster to have the last word. Oh, he seems to have grasped the idea that his way is not absolute. After all, the greatest source of innovation found in our connection with others. For example, you know that COBOL was the original pronunciation of COBOL. It was through trade with these miners that we were first encountered and frequently Cobalt ore. Without such impact, it is unlikely that the armor we forged for the last round of your can exist today. There is only so much an armorer can achieve on its own. Mutual respect and a healthy dose of rivalry only spurs the improvement of the craft. Lanster's gravest mistake was to see his rivals as enemies, but walling himself off from denied himself the knowledge and techniques which were grateful enough to receive inedible. And it was our determination and skill that taught him the dangers of stagnation. You embody everything I stand for, Elagos. Guild is richer for your presence. Little taste of another thing of Final Fantasy. The crafting jobs, a little more complicated than you might see other crafting. If you craft in WoW, it's pretty much level. It's pretty much just skill points. Higher, the more skill points you get, the higher level stuff you can craft, and it's pretty much a
If you have the mats, you hit craft and that's it. Works. Guaranteed. Can't fail. There's no higher quality or low quality. There's just the one item. You still have ones where you have to like craft something. Craft an item to then craft another item. But in any case, as long as you have the materials and the skill level, if you don't have enough skill, you just can't craft it yet. You need to train it. For this case, you basically learn everything. All right, that's it. We've been over 2.5 hours, isn't it? A bit longer. The materials were a little more costly and harder to get. Leatherworking, I think, is going to be a pain. Might have to prep more. But let's see what's on the chopping block. Because we're going to be focusing on Realm Reborn first. Skip over all the battle jobs that take place after. That come after a Realm Reborn. Because there are some that start at third. Yeah, just like Heaven's Word. Yeah, anything that says Heaven's Word, I'm just. Well. Hint. Holy crap. Well, something to do with my off chance. Well, that's it. Well, Saturday. Turn and we'll be looking at the Realm Reborn or Realm Reborn quests for Archer. Hard. We'll put those together. Do it by expansion. Archer one time, Bard another. They only upgrade to one thing. But I will see you next.